Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today I'm gonna be talking how we can render glasses much more realistically. It's still gonna be a fake, but it's gonna look better. So I have a lovely scene with a glass here, and now if I apply a glass material to this, it looks like this. So I'm currently with the legacy mode. Even if I apply the physical material, my scene looks like this. Which is all cool. Like, this is the, you know, this is the glass that we are all used to seeing in renders, and that's just how it looks. But then as I was walking through my kitchen, I stumbled upon this scenario. So this glass, I noticed one thing. There is a damn hard shadow here. And that shadow, we don't really see in our render. It looks like it's pretty much floating without a shadow, right? So at that point, you know, I was thinking, okay, yeah, that's probably because, you know, I don't have an actual caustics in this whole scene. So I turned on caustics in my scene, and would you look at this? I got a nice shadow with, like, you know, the little caustic streaks and all that. The same as you can see here. We got, you know, the shadow, the streaks, and that's all cool. But then there is a reason why people, like the majority of people, don't use caustics, because it's super slow to render. And then I was thinking, okay, so rendering caustics in a daily, you know, grind, let's call it like that, is not really something that you want to go for. So I was thinking there has to be a way on how I can, you know, not use caustics and get pretty much this effect. So let me just take, you know, the caustics image and put it here, sort of like a reference, and let's see if I can maybe try to kind of replicate this shadowy, you know, caustics effect without, like I said, actually using caustics. So first thing that I want to do is I want to match the shadow. So we got the dark shadow here, and then we got, you know, the light elements piercing through. So I want to match that, since, you know, 100% refraction doesn't have anything to cost shadows. So let me lower down refraction so much that I match the intensity of the shadowing. Let's set refraction to, I don't know, 0.8. Okay. Of course, our glass doesn't very, like, really look like glass anymore, but we are seeing some sort of shadow. Comparing to the one on the left, it has to be, like, more dark, so let's go 0.6. I think this is maybe a bit too much, but, you know, like, looking at these parts, I think it kind of matches. So, I don't know, let's go 0.65. Okay, so we got ourselves a shadow. Now, how do we make the glass to look like glass, but still cast shadows? So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to right click on my material editor, go to Corona, and I'm going to choose the Corona Ray Switch material. Let me just click on my glass material and let's make it a completely, you know, glass material without any refraction lowerings. And I'm going to plug that into the reflect override, refract override, and direct override. Let me just first apply the ray switch material to my glass. And now for the global illumination, I'm just gonna create a plain material and I'm gonna plug it into global illumination. Now, would you look at this? We got our glass looking as a glass and we got the shadow. But where are the little streaks? Like, where are all the caustic effects? Since our plain material here is driving the see-throughness of the whole glass, and the glass has some sort of shape, I was thinking, how can I kind of, you know, tell Max that this is a specific shape and, you know, some parts need to pass lights, some parts don't need to pass lights, etc. And the only thing that I came up with is a standard fall off. So right click, go to maps, general, and click on fall off. Now plug that fall off into the opacity slot and look what happens. We got ourselves pretty much a fake caustics effect, you know, without actually using caustics. And this is rendering now in real time. Okay, now, the position of the rays is not, you know, really that much visible. You know, like, there is a see-throughness happening, but let's see if we can kind of, you know, crank it up. So go to your falloff, scroll down where it says output, and here enable color map. And here we're pretty much gonna contrast the falloff map and we're gonna try to kind of pronounce these effects. So if I right click on the upper dot, click on bezier corner, on the lower dot, bezier corner, and now look at this. If I just, you know, put this here, put this one here, like make a very big contrast. Like, as you can see, I'm even going below the black line here. Look what's happening. We actually got some sort of, you know, fake shape, you know, happening here. And since my darkness here is kind of lost, you can just play with the values and just, you know, let's say lift this one a little bit up, maybe a little bit more up. And after tweaking some more, you know, with the settings, just try to add like a point in here and just, you know, play with these contrasts, because what you're doing here, you're actually, you know, allowing that fall off in the opacity to pass through in, you know, various shapes. Again, from this point, you pretty much just try to kind of play with the settings. You know, as you can see, like as I'm lowering this point, I'm passing more light here. Like when it was up, it was like much darker. So that way you can, you know, kind of customize, you know, like what's being see-through, what's not being see-through. And you're gonna get a much more, you know, kind of realistic, much more natural effect off your glasses without actually using caustics. So yeah, this is generally, you know, my way on how I set up my glass materials. I always use the little override function just to get those nice caustic-like shadows. Again, this is not real caustics, but you know, it does a pretty good job comparing that, you know, you don't have the render time of the caustic scene. And as usual, see you in the next video. Bye.